Hello and welcome to the Studying Geology lecture of Bauxite. So in this topic we will cover first how they form, second the suitable conditions for the formation of bauxite, third is the minerals present, that is their mineralogy, and fourth is the Indian occurrences of these deposits. Let's start with the bauxite on how they form. So bauxite deposits are of residual origin. This means that whenever there is a cover present of aluminium rich rock, like here is a rock of granite which has feldspar KAlSi3O8, this is K feldspar. It also has plagioclase, means calcium or sodium feldspars are also there, which are also rich in aluminium. So whenever the weathering of these types of rocks occur, the silicates break. The silicates are break and they weathered, and upper cover is usually becomes enriched in aluminium and iron oxides. So here the aluminium becomes rich in the residual rocks, so therefore these types of deposits are called residual types of deposits. Now we can see what are the suitable conditions under which these types of deposits can form. So these are the conditions, and here you can see first is the source rock. So as I mentioned before, that source rock should be aluminium rich, such as granite, syenite and basalt. Granite rocks, syenite rocks, basalt rocks can be the good source rocks for bauxite deposit because they all have aluminium containing minerals in them. Second is the climate. So for weathering, the rainfall must be there. So humid tropical to subtropical climate where rainfall is abundant are the most suitable climatic conditions for bauxite formation. So here we can write, humid tropical to subtropical and third is pH, like acidic or basic conditions. So the high pH conditions are favored, means the basic conditions are favored for formation of these types of deposits, for the bauxite deposits, because at the specific pH and EH conditions the silica breaks, and these conditions, the high pH condition in basic conditions favors the breaking of silica at the surface. Fourth is topography. Topography means is the terrains, how the terrain should be. So the flat terrains which permits slow downward infiltration are the best suitable. So here we looked at the conditions. Now we will next move to the mineralogy, that is the minerals present in the bauxite. So first is gibbsite. As you can see, the gibbsite has the Al2O3.3H2O formula. There are three molecules of water are present with it. Second is boehmite. Boehmite has only one molecule of H2O. And third is diaspor, that is AlOOH. So here the going downward the water content is decreasing. Gibbsite, boehmite and diaspor, these three are important to remember. Now we can come to our Indian occurrences. So here in India, as you can see, these are in the Gujarat and some are also in Maharashtra, which are not mentioned here, like Ratnagiri also contains bauxite deposits. These are in the central India, Jharkhand and Orissa. And in the South India, here you can also see these deposits, which are in Gujarat and Maharashtra, are formed by Deccan basalt, because the area, this whole topography is suitable. High rainfall, high precipitation is there. Abundant rainfall occurs in the Maharashtra region, Mumbai region, near Mumbai, and also here in the Gujarat. Secondly, flat terrains, source rock is good, so bauxite deposit formed here. Most important ones are here in the east. These deposits formed on Khondalite rocks. Khondalite rocks are the source rock for these deposits. Pachpatmali is the important. Amarkantak plateau is also important one. Palmau deposits. And in the South India, Yarkud and Belkam, these deposits are also very important. Yarkud is also formed on Khondalite. So you should remember these names related to bauxite deposits in India. Thank you very much for watching.